Let us pray. Lord, eternal rock of ages, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, Alpha and Omega, to you be the glory. You are the one that changes not. Thank you for the privilege given to telecast your words through the new technology all over the world. Thank you for what you are doing right now and what you do. Take absolute control of this ministration in your precious name. Amen and amen. You are welcome to this telecast. I know you will be blessed tremendously. I want to pay special attention to this ministration. God bless you. The scripture is taken from the book of Acts of Apostle, the third chapter. Acts of Apostle, the third chapter. It was in a certain day that there are two men, devoted men. They just volunteered to do something extraordinary, which brought a spectacular miracle to their vicinity. Listen, when I read the third chapter, Acts of Apostles, I commence from first verse. Now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour, and a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple, who seen Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked and hands. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, "Look on us." And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter says, "Silver and gold have I none, but just as I have given thee, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God, and they knew it was he who sat for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at which that happened unto him. And the lame man, which was healed, heard Peter and John. All the people ran together unto him in the porch. That is called Solomon's, greatly wondering. Praise the living Jesus. You say, let us pray. Lord, we thank you for a time like this. Oh Lord, we want to extract from the scripture reading. May you take absolute control in Jesus' name. Amen. The theme of this sermon is sudden miracle. Sudden miracle. You see, miracle happens when somebody cares. Miracle happens when someone cares. According to the reading of the Holy Scripture, after the arrival of Holy Spirit, that was pointed to the Acts of Apostles, the second chapter. When Jesus was leaving the planet, Jesus said, "I will send you the Comforter, because I have to go to the Father. If I didn't go to the Father, the Comforter will not come." And that is the Holy Spirit. That was why They gathered, they were praying on that fateful day in the upper room. And what happened? God Almighty in His majesty, Jesus Christ, His only begotten Son, they never lie. The Creator never lie. The Bible said the Holy Spirit came and split itself like a tongue of fire, in which all receive the Holy Spirit, speaking in different tongues. Even go you go to for studies somewhere else, even the higher institution, from elementary to secondary to college. Unless you undergo training for a certain degree before you can be able to make use of what you have attained, your major. But this time around, Holy Spirit, the supernatural power of God, worked miracle. Everything was just freely. People were hearing themselves speaking their languages, the power of God. And after that, something miraculously happened. The third chapter of the After Apostles, what happened there? Peter and John, you know this guy was a faithful servant of God, of Jesus Christ, in Jesus trust. Jesus called him the rock. Why? Because he's always bold. He behaved in a bold way all the time. You know it as a Christian. So they made up their mind one day that they will go and pray. They went together with John. They prayed fervent prayer. You know, I'm pointing to the prayer point that prayer works miracle. They did not even say the fast, no. Prayer. They went for prayer. They went there on the top, mountain top, and started praying, Lord, have mercy, give us power. You have given the Holy Spirit, let miracle. Different type of prayer, I could not even explain right now. You know what happened? After the matter prayed, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. They were converted to be a new creature in the same body. And they were coming down from the mountain with empowerment of Holy Spirit in them. As they were coming down, you see, they had the weapon, the power to heal. And God made way for them. What way? They were passing through the beautiful gate of the temple. Because maybe they were heading to the temple that very particular period of time. And there was a guy always sitting down all the time, asking for money from people to sustain himself because he could not walk nothing. He was a lame man. He specifically asked for financial support. From who? From John and Peter. These servants of men, they didn't have anything to give. In time of silver and gold, material things of this world. But they have something. They have something supernatural. And what was that something? The power of Holy Ghost they received from Jesus from the upper room was with them, which they could give free of charge. Praise the Lord. And this is my game. Man, please, can you help me with something to feed? He was expecting money, slipper and gold, that is money. And the Bible said, Peter, a bold man, even in the time of Jesus Christ, always bold, always bold. You know Peter, as a Christian, any area, Peter always make sure he made a statement and Jesus will just answer. You remember Peter? When Jesus said, today, before cockcrow call, you will... Peter said, no, I will not. Then it came to pass. He repented. Jesus was walking on the sea, Peter was jumping on the sea with Jesus. He was doubting, he was sinking. Jesus brought him. There are a lot of occasions. At this juncture, Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit after prayer. After what? After prayer, mark it, after prayer. Not just as enter into a restaurant or somewhere, fill up his belly and start No, nothing could happen with that. But Holy Spirit, the food of the Spirit, which is prayer, was inside Peter. Peter fastened his face. He said, look unto us. That is in the 6th, the Acts of Apostles, 3rd chapter, the 6th verse. Let me read. Then Peter said, slaver, and go, have I known, but as I have given ID in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and what? And walk. Not only to rise, and walk. Rise and walk. What a command. A supernatural command of Jesus. The power from the upper room on the day of Pentecost that followed Peter and John to the mountain. See manifestation right now. The seventh verse. And he took him up by the right hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet, ankle, bones received what? Strength. Praise the Lord. You see the supernatural power of Jesus Christ? That is what God can do. The Creator still has power to use the vessels. Peter, a fisherman, he can use you. Just surrender yourself. Peter was a fisherman, but now he's not a fisherman again. He's a new creation who could command, and something spectacular happened. That was why that man, Hanku. Let's read the 8th chapter. And he lifted up, stood, and walked, and entered with them unto the temple. Praise the living Jesus. Somebody was there for how many years? Many years here. Begging for money. Give me every day. They brought him there, pick him up home every day. But this day is a different day. In the name of Jesus, a different day will come to your existence. Your endeavors, a system, a new day, a new dawn is coming to you as you are hearing this ministration. Anything that is in the replica of a lame man who could not help himself, but now, through prayer of Peter and commanding of Holy Spirit through Peter, something miraculously happened. The manifestation of Holy Spirit happened. The same thing will apply to your life. In the name of Jesus, amen. In verse 9, and all the people saw him walking and praising God. Praise the Lord. All people, not only one, not two, not three, numerous people. They knew him there. It was not a stage miracle from nowhere. They knew him there all the time, begging for money. They give him money every time. They knew him. And this Peter and John, nobody knew them. They are from nowhere. But God commanded them to pass through this very man so that he could retain this miracle. The power of God will allow your people, any people that God will use to help you, to pass through you, and you receive your miracle too. In the name of Jesus, amen. In verse 10, see what happened. And they knew that it was he which sat for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonders and amazement at that which had happened unto him. Why wonders? Why amazement? Because it is this supernatural. It's what? Supernatural. Every time they saw this guy beside the temple of beautiful gate, begging for money, and they were giving him money every day until that day when God said, you, Peter and John, walk around. Take him up. And this was how happened. Today, what is the problem that is making you to yourself in an anxiety period. You are afraid. You don't know what to do again. You are at the crossroad. But do you know that there's somebody there, God Almighty, who sent Jesus to the world? As he has done for that man at the beautiful gate, the same thing he will do for you. In the name of Jesus, say amen to that. Amen. In the verse 11, and as the lame man which was healed had Peter and John, all the people ran together unto them in the porch, which is called Solomon's Great Wandering. This was a spectacular area called Solomon's Great Wandering. It was a place I mark just like a resort, an excursion period, where people always visit. That's why God arranged this very guy to receive his miracle, which is a permanent law. Permanent miracle is not a staged miracle. In the name of Jesus, receive your miracle too. Receive your miracle too. Receive your miracle too. In Jesus' name. Amen. You see, when this thing happened, people were amazed. They were astonished. They were wondering, because this type of situation has never happened before, except in the life of Jesus Christ before he died and resurrection and ascension to heaven, that the power he dropped down through the disciples continue manifesting. So let's see. Peter said something here. And when Peter saw it, he answered to the people, "Ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this? Or why look ye earnestly on us, as though by our own power or holiness we have made this man to walk?" See? Peter challenged them. Not by our power, not by our holiness, that this miracle, the supernatural miracle, has happened to this man. This man has been at the beautiful gate, but he was in the ugly situation. May God have mercy on us in Jesus' name. Your ugly situation will become beautiful in Jesus' name. See, the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, the God of our Father, which has glorified his Son, Jesus, whom you delivered up and deliver in the presence of the Pilate, where it was determined to let him go. And you deny the Holy One and just, and desire a murderer to be granted unto you. You can see the situation. Peter was trying to extract some facts there. Jesus before the Pilate. Pilate was agitating among these two people, whom do you want him to be released? And they said, "Set free Barnabas." What about Jesus? Crucified him. Jesus was crucified because of me, because of you. Because he was not crucified, we won't get the salvation. He got in Matthew in the book of Revelation chapter 5. Nobody was able to come to the wall. But Jesus said, "Let me go." He came here. When he was here, in the Garden of Gethsemane, he saw the vision revelations. "Oh Lord, if this cup let me pass over me. But thy will be done." Thy will, he went to the grave. Thy will, God raised him up. Thy will, he ascended to heaven. His will be done. He gave us salvation. Praise the Lord. Then he dropped the Holy Spirit. The same thing working miracle. If you're a true man of God, the same thing is working in your life. We have been praying for people of different calibers. Where do you want to go and receive your prayer? It's only through Jesus. He's using us. Call for prayer. Salvation is free. And you will be blessed. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy to your life today. The same miracle that happened in the life of the lame man. Anything in the replica of lameness, physically, spiritually, and materially, it will turn around for your good. any name of Jesus. Because it is today, tomorrow, and forever. The man at the pool of Bethesda, 38 years, the same similar incident happened to him. The woman who touched the issue of the garment of Jesus with the issue of blood vanished. Jairus' daughter was healed. There are a lot of miracles that it will be a turnaround. Good turnaround is coming your way. In the name of Jesus, have faith in God. Faith is what Jesus needs. Abraham is the father of faith. When God commanded Abraham, Abraham, go there, sir. Abraham said, yes, sir. Abraham will just move to the altar. Abraham never argued with God. Do not argue with your creator. If you say, move. Sit, get up. That is what God wants. Just obedience is better than a sacrifice. Praise the Lord. When you obey God, He is the creator of the universe. We could only see with our physical eyes, but God knows visible and the invisible. All the technologies of this world, the technology that are operating through the airwaves. You can communicate through the airwaves. In form of technical, you can even see through your cell phone, you can see the picture, you can communicate, you can send messages, you can write. Where is the technology for the soul? No, God will not show you that. He has never shown anybody. The technology of the soul, when the soul leaves the body and pass on, God will never show that one. Jesus was showing that when you live here, if you believe me, you see me over there. If you don't believe me, I'm sorry. Go. Come unto me, you that are heavy laden. I will give you rest. That is what Jesus said. Come unto me. Heavy laden, there are different dimensions of heavy laden. You know your own, I know my own. The only solution to that problem is the Son of God, whom God has given unto the whole. Because the book of John 3, John, the third chapter, chapter 3, verse 16, says, for God so loved the world, He has given us His only begotten Son. Whoever believes will not perish, but have eternal life. In the book of John, the 14th chapter, 1-3, it says, do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God Almighty, His Father. Also in Him, the Son. In the Father's house, that is God's house, there are many mansions. Not the mansion that is perishable like the one we have now, like the studio you're hearing me. All the big mansions in different cities. No, not that mansion I'm talking about. Mansions of the beautiful city Jerusalem. Incorruptible. Imperishable, immortal. That's where the soul, Jesus wants our soul to go. Because the soul is incorruptible. The soul never dies. He wants your soul to be there. My soul to be there at the end of our short journey of this life. Either we live 120 years or whatever years, He wants us to come. He is here waiting for us. Waiting for you. Are you? Do you believe that Jesus can take you to that place? A very beautiful place. Oh Lord, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Try to pray fervently. Read your Bible, listen to gospel music. Gospel music, read your Bible. You will be uplifted in the realm of the Spirit. You can go to church. Mingle yourself with the true men, people of God. To our spiritual life is very, very important. Peter and John, they were common fishermen picked by the bank of the rivers, catching fish there. When Jesus was making His disciples, He said, follow me, I will make you the fishers of men. They followed Him. To the hand, to what? To the hand. And you remember, they have nice places to live over there with Jesus when they ended their life in the discipleship. Bible made us to understand that these people, they were faithful to God. Through their life to the end of their life. May God give us the privilege to continue in the doctrine of Christ to the time when he will come. Because he has given us opportunity. What is your own talent? Make use of your talent to praise God. You can sing music, sing to the glory of God. Evangelize the word of God. Praise the gospel. He said, go ye into the world and praise the gospel to the all nooks and corners of the world. Your inheritance is over there. The prayer is going on right now. So if you need prayer, we have already announced people who are interested in prayer. Give us a call. And you will be glad you did. Mercy on you. Amen. I know you have been blessed tremendously during the ministration. And I pray that the anointing of Jesus Christ will be upon every one of us. And as we have already given the ministration according to the God's direction, may God bless each and every one of you. And for more information about the ministration, do not hesitate to contact us through the right connections right on the screen there. So you can communicate through any model of information right there on the screen. I pray that God will not leave you alone. He will find lasting solution to all your problems, physically, spiritually, and financially. And the salvation, which is so precious, will not be taken away from us. In the name of Jesus, remain blessed. Amen.